Hello everyone, welcome back in the second part of tricks and tips to make your art amazing with Clip Studio Paint. I'm Qsan, and today I'll creating custom materials to enrich a character illustration. Let's start! In the previous video, I showed you how to make fast and easy styles using the border effect. Now, let's try to create decorations. After you have an idea of what materials you need, go to Menu, File, New, and create a new canvas with the same settings as your illustration. Usually I work on A4, A3 canvas size with 300-350 resolution. Click OK. Let's start drawing the first material, a compass rose. Create a folder and drag and drop all layers into it. Go to Tool, Figure, Direct Draw, and Lips, and draw circles, one outside and two inside. Right click, merge with layer below. Create a new layer, go to Tool, Ruler, Symmetrical Ruler. In Tool Property, change the number of line to 4. Go to Tool, Figure, Direct Draw, Straight Line, and start to draw the compass rose. As you can see, the drawing magically appears in all 4 sides around the ruler. Repeat the same process, putting the symmetrical ruler in a different angle and in the same layer. Refine the compass rose, adding line details, and scale the shape going to Tool, Edit, Transformation, Scale Rotate. Done! Keeping the same layer, go to Tool, Ruler, Symmetrical Ruler. Change the number of line to 2, put the ruler in the layer and draw a cute grapefruit hair clip. Go to the Tool, Operation, Object, Tool Property, and check Snap. With these options, I'm able to draw more elements using an existing ruler. You can move and rotate it by using the points near to the line or changing the center X, center Y, and angle value. Done! Then, draw the gold button using the same ruler. Go to Tool, GPen, and start to draw a simple decoration. If you want to draw handmade parts in the same layer, go to the layer, right-click on the ruler, and uncheck Show Ruler. By doing this, I'd activated the ruler function in the layer without deleting it. Then, go to Tool, Figure, Direct Draw, and with Rectangle, draw the outside shapes. Done! Now let's do laces and flowers. The process is the same. Activate the symmetrical ruler again, then go to Tool, Ruler, Symmetrical Ruler. Change the number of lines as you prefer, I changed the number of lines to 14. The final result will be always different and magical. Deactivate the ruler and go to the tool, selection area, rectangle to select your drawing and move it in the canvas. With the same ruler as before and with the G pen, start to draw another decorated lace. Feel free to combine undrawn parts with the ruler parts by checking and unchecking the show ruler. To create a laced ribbon, create a new lace by going to Tool, Ruler, Symmetrical Ruler. Deactivate the ruler function and go to selection area, rectangle, and copy and paste the same lace. Merge with layer below. Again, go into selection area, rectangle, and cut the drawing in half. Then, go to Tool, Ruler, Symmetrical Ruler. With the number of lines set to 6, draw a small lace in the middle. Now create undrawn roses, daisies, and random flowers using the symmetrical ruler. Once finished, create a new layer under the line art layer and color all elements using the illustration color palette as reference. Now let's create custom brushes. Go to the line art layer, right click, merge layer below. So we have a unique layer again. Go to the tool, selection area, lasso. Select the daisy in the front. Go to menu, edit, register material, image. Write a name for your material and activate these settings. Use for paper texture, use for brush tip shape, scale up, down. Then save the material in a standard folder or a custom one. But don't forget to add the tag. It will be useful to create your custom brush. Then click OK. Repeat the same process with the other materials you want to use as brush. Once you are finished, go to the tool GPen, right click, duplicate subtool, or click the second icon at the bottom. Change the name as you prefer, I called it Flowers Kimono. Go to tool property, subtool detail palette, brush tip, tip shape, material. Brush tip shape icon will become active. Click on it and open your materials list. Go to type search keywords and write search your custom tag. You will only see the custom materials in the right. Find your flowers, select them and click OK. The brush is almost ready, let's add some distance between each flower. Go to Stroke, Gap, activate it and select the Fixed option. Then, change the value as you prefer to add or decrease the quantity of the flowers in the stroke. Then, go to Repeat method, Random, so the flower will appear randomly in the stroke. Remember to activate the eye next to the gap. The option will appear directly in the tool property and it will be more easy to change the value if you need. Close the window. Go to tool property, click the icon near to the brush size dynamics, and activate the pen pressure. Without this, the brush will not be affected by pressure and the stroke will be more even. This is the result. Repeat the same process with other materials you want to convert in brush. For the laced ribbon, remember to select the central part only and convert it into material. duplicate again the GPen and change the name in custom laced ribbon. Go to Tool Property, Subtool Detail Palette, Brush Tip, Tip Shape, Material. Put the same settings as the previous brush, but when you go in Stroke, only select the ribbon option. The pattern will automatically be separated with a regular distance. Again, go to Brush Tip, Angle, and change the value to merge your lace. I changed it to 90. Done! In a few steps, we created a lot of materials using only the symmetrical ruler and a lot of creativity. Using this type of tool gives a lot of inspiration and freedom. You can create any type of decoration, stickers and patterns, giving you a huge help for your character art illustration. I hope this first part was helpful for you to create your own materials. Don't hesitate to share your ideas with us. Thanks for watching and see you in the last part, enriching the blonde girl's imagination. Bye!